Greetings to you all. I have been waiting for this opportunity for over 2 years, and it's finally happened. In the end of May 2023, I was granted access to the legendary BFI IMAX theater. BFI IMAX is the largest cinema screen in the United Kingdom, and in this video you will get a detailed tour of the cinema, including a sneak peek of the backstage area, which is not accessible to general public. Just before I start, I'd like to encourage you to subscribe to BoardTech channel. It is very important, as your subscriptions are helping me to open doors into exciting places like this IMAX theater. If you would like to support BoardTech channel financially, you can use the Super Thanks feature here on YouTube or consider becoming a patron on Patreon. You will find all the links in the description down below. Let's start with a little bit of history. BFI IMAX was designed by Brian Avery and completed in May 1999. It is located in the middle of a roundabout just 100 meters away from famous Waterloo Station. The building is surrounded by traffic and has the Waterloo and City Line just 4 meters below it. To keep the auditorium as quiet as possible, architects and engineers accounted for this in their design, and the entire upper structure sits on anti-vibration bearings to prevent noise incursion. In 2012, the screen was replaced and digital 2K IMAX xenon projectors were installed alongside an existing 70mm IMAX GT projector. BFI IMAX has been managed by Odeon for almost 10 years, but on 19th of July 2022, BFI regained control of the operations. On the same day, it closed its doors to the public so a major upgrade could take place. You will see what exactly was upgraded a little bit later in this video. The cinema reopened in November 2022, perfectly on time for Black Panther: Wakanda Forever premiere. Great! Come in and let's have a detailed look at the largest IMAX screen in the UK. On the ground floor foyer you will find the box office, cafe, bar and even a poster signed by Christopher Nolan. As soon as you walk up the stairs, you emerge into the upper foyer, which is located right under the auditorium. Here you can get yourself some snacks, sweets or refreshments. But the real fun starts when you enter the 500 seats auditorium. In the tallest part, the distance between the floor and the ceiling is over 20 meters. Another thing that you may notice as soon as you enter the auditorium is that it's very quiet, with barely any echoing or reverberation. It means that the acoustics of the building will not interact with the movie soundtrack and will not add any unwanted artifacts into the movie soundscape. Seats are separated by stairs into three sections. They are quite steep stairs. It is because IMAX raking is way steeper than in a regular cinema. This basically eliminates the problem of someone in front of you blocking the view. During the refurbishment in October 2022, a brand new screen was installed. It measures 26 meters wide and almost 20 meters high, and its aspect ratio is 1.43 to 1. Which is a native 70mm IMAX film aspect ratio. To fill the largest screen in the UK with stunning moving images, BFI has quite a few projection systems. Of course, you can find the legendary IMAX GT projector here. It is capable of playing 15 perforations 70mm movies. The heart of the projector is a water-cooled 15,000 watts xenon lamp, which is only lives about 1,000 hours, then it has to be replaced. During the 2022 refurbishment, the old digital 2K xenon projectors were replaced with this new generation laser light source 4K projector, which can produce a picture twice as bright as the old system. The only flaw is that this projector cannot fill the entire screen. Its aspect ratio is 1.90:1, which means that the small section of the screen at the top and the bottom will remain unused. I don't see a problem with this, as most IMAX versions of movies shot on digital cameras are using this exact aspect ratio. When you want to play a 1.43:1 movie, you can always use the legendary IMAX GT projector. Behind the screen I have found a very interesting equipment rack. It appears that they are amplifiers for the transducers that shake the screen. The thing is that the laser light source projector has an undesired quality that causes it to speckle on colors. In order to minimize this effect, there are transducers installed all over the structure that slightly shake the screen to minimize the speckle. Frequency is generated and later amplified by the equipment in this rack. For non-IMAX 3D, they are using dual Christie CP2000XB projectors. Besides that, there is also a Century JJ projector, which is capable of playing 35 and 70 mm film. Sound on 35 and 70 mm is usually reproduced using Dolby or DTS processors, which are also installed here at BFI IMAX. I think now it would be a good moment to have a look at the sound systems. What I really love about the screen at BFI IMAX is that they installed lights behind it to make the speakers visible. I haven't seen the sound system being backlit in any other cinema. Let me know in the comments below if you know any other cinema that does it. After seeing such a variety of different projection systems, it is not a surprise that BFI IMAX has two sound systems installed in the auditorium. Speakers on the 7.1 system are a mixture of Louis Westman and JBL. These four subwoofers are made by a Spanish professional speaker manufacturer Louis Westman. Surround speakers are manufactured by JBL. Left, center and right are again Louis Westman, and center left and center right are two-way JBLs. All this sonic beauty is powered by BGW and Omnex ProFilm amplifiers. I will leave the links to all manufacturers' webpages in the description of this video. The first thing that comes to your mind when you hear about IMAX is a giant image. However, in IMAX theaters, the sound has to be huge too, in order to keep up with the visuals on a massive screen. You can see four Kenga speakers behind the screen. These Kenga speakers were installed during the refurbishment in 2012 and are still top of the range today. You will find left, right, center and the high center speakers behind the screen. High center channel is something that you can only see in IMAX theaters. It is here to add vertical dimension to the soundscape and take full advantage of the 20 meters high screen. Each speaker is powered by a separate IMAX AM5 amplifier. These brand new amplifiers were installed during the refurbishment last year. IMAX Kenga are the three-way speakers. I was surprised that such a huge speakers were not bi-amped or even 3-amps. It would be very interesting to find out why such a configuration was chosen. There are two other Kenga speakers which represent left and right surround channels in the rear corners of the auditorium. During the refurbishment, 6 extra channels were added. That includes 2 side channels and 4 ceiling channels. These new speakers create a sphere which envelops the viewer in almost 360 degrees of sound. Unfortunately, new channels remain unused for 1570 presentations because the old system only supports 6 channels. I would like to take a look at the subwoofers, which are located right in the middle of the screen. I was surprised to find out that IMAX not using 15-inch or even 18-inch drivers. Instead, they have 12-inch drivers for the subwoofers. They are 8 subwoofers installed in the auditorium, which are powered by these two IMAX AM4 amplifiers. Each subwoofer has 4 12-inch drivers in it, which brings the total number to a crazy 32 drivers. But what is even more interesting is their arrangement behind the screen. As I have mentioned earlier, they are located right in the center and placed sideways facing each other. I believe that this unusual solution helps to form even low-frequency waves that cover the whole auditorium. Sometimes you can spot similar solutions being used for live events. So, this was the tour of BFI IMAX, the largest cinema screen in the United Kingdom. It was the first IMAX that I visited in the UK back in 2014. To this day, it remains at the top of my favorite cinemas list. This is one of the few theaters that really care about the quality of the presentation. I realize that you need a lot of cinema goers to cover the cost of very expensive equipment and hire highly skilled professionals. If you have never been here, you should definitely visit BFI IMAX. Now is a really good moment as they are still screening Oppenheimer on 1570 IMAX film. This is it for this video. Please share your experience about the theater in the comments below. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.